rose up. It's the time for us to give God our highest praise, our best praise. Can we just give God a shout of triumph for being God, for being sovereign, for being our protection and our provider? Hallelujah. God, we come today to give you all that we have. God, we come today seeking your face and seeking a touch from you. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We
lift our hands and thank God today that we are his friends. I want to take this time right now. Everyone, let's meet and greet one another real quick. Come on, this is an opportunity to share with a couple people. Say hi to two or three people real quick.
Hey. it to you, God. We owe you, God. Come on, this is
do the Lord better than that. Come on, let's give him a great big hand of praise. God, if you will. Come on, stand to your feet, give him praise. Come on, stand to your feet, give him praise.
When you got it, say, I got it. 22-25. This is the first testament. You should be able to find it pretty quickly. Exodus chapter number 30, verses 22-25. If you got it, let me hear great big, I got it. All right. The Bible says, it says, take thou also unto thee. I'm reading from the New King James. I'm sorry. Let me read it for you on the screen so y'all can do the thuses and the these and the thous. Moreover, the Lord spoke to Moses, saying also, take for yourself quality spices, 500 shekels of liquid myrrh, half as much sweet-smelling cinnamon, 250 shekels, 250 shekels of sweet-smelling cane, 500 shekels of cassia, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, and a hin of olive oil. And you shall make for these a holy anointing oil, an anointment compounded according to the art of the performer. It shall be a holy anointing oil. Father, I thank you so very much for this opportunity this afternoon to declare your word. Father, I thank you, God, that as you drop this on my heart this afternoon, I know it's for somebody. There is an anointing present to destroy every yoke of bondage. And Father, I thank you this afternoon, God, that your word will not return void, but it will accomplish the thing that you will send to it, and it will prosper to it. I thank you, God, for your presence this afternoon. Help my mind and my mouth this afternoon declare your heart and your word. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Come on, give him a great big hand of praise, everybody. Amen. You may be seated this afternoon. Well, the Lord really dealt with me and called an audible on me this afternoon. The responsibility of the preacher is to hear from God. And I think it's important for us to want that. We want to hear from God. We don't want to come to church just to hear the same old regular rituals and routines. We want to be able to hear a word from God. Well, this morning the Lord began to deal with me, and I'm going to be preaching from this title, New Oil for My Next Level. Look at somebody say, New Oil for My Next Level. Say with some authority, new oil for my next level. Well, traditionally in the church world, today is the day of Pentecost, where the church was birthed and born. Most oftentimes in Pentecostal circles, the only thing we focus on is when people speak in tongues. But we don't realize that the day of Pentecost was about the birth of the church. And we have to realize that the birth of the church was very unique because it came through a time of adversity and persecution. Most oftentimes, people think that, you know, doing God's work is easy. We have to realize that as believers, that doing God's work isn't necessarily easy.
easy. It does not always, it isn't always comfortable to do what God has called us to do. It requires hardness sometimes. It requires preservation sometimes. It requires us to be able to push through difficulties, to be able to see God move in our life. And it's interesting because when I see the church was birthed through pressure and persecution. And I know that there's somebody in the room that's like, God, it's been crazy. It's been a crazy season. Been through a lot of pressure, a lot of persecution. I don't know why the struggle has really been real in this season of my life. And God told me to prophetically declare to you it's new oil for your next level. You may think that is that the enemy wants to keep you where you are and that your circumstances and your situations are designed to keep you locked up, but really it's designed to pull out of you your next level. The pressure that is on you is designed to pull out of you the anointing and the oil that God wants to produce in your life to take you to the next level. How many of you are ready for your next place? Yeah. You realize here, man, in the early church, in the book of Acts here, in the book of Acts, we're not going to read it, but the early church here, Jesus has just died. He was crucified. You got to realize that these were people that were talked about. These were people that were almost in certain ways hunted for death, and they had to learn how to put God first to be able to birth what he wants. They gathered in an inner room. They gathered together to mourn and to weep about their Savior, but then power came on them as a result of the pressure. I want to say this. There are no screen notes today. You got to hear me with your spirit and with your ears this afternoon. That your next level usually starts with problems. Yeah. Most of us are like wondering, well, God, why in the world that if you're ushering me to my next place, why is there always so many problems? Yeah. Because the problems produce the pressure on your life to release the oil that's in you. Yeah. And let me tell you something. Some of you all have been kind of playing and teetering-tottering in this thing, but God is trying to get some oil out of your life. God wants to be able to see the residue of his presence and his anointing on your life. And so that's why it seems like the things are mounting and stacking against you, is because it's to produce the pressure to produce the oil in your life. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. Well, over here in the book of Exodus, why is this important? Because when I'm thinking about the oil and the anointing, you have to think about the process by which it took to produce the anointing oil. If you would allow me to talk through this afternoon, I'm going to get out of your way in a little bit. The Bible says here, this is from the New King James. Y'all going to have to hear it, okay? It says, moreover, the Lord spake to Moses, saying, he says, take thou also the principal spices. Why is this important? He says, take the quality spices. I want you to take the best spices. I want you to take the best of the best. I don't want you to give me your last. I don't want you to give me nothing that don't require sacrifice. I don't want you to give me what's easy. I want you to give me what requires sacrifice. I want you to dig for this. And this is in the season of your life. You're saying, God, I need you to break forward in my finances and break out in my life. God is saying, you got to learn how to give me the best, not what's comfortable. Oh, somebody say amen. Yeah, so I can't give you what's comfortable. I can't give you what's easy. I can't give you the 10 when I got the 20. I got to learn how to, I got to be principled in this. I got to give God the best to produce the oil in my life. So he says, moreover, the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, take thou unto thee the principal spices. And then he says, I want you to take 500 shekels of pure myrrh. So literally 500 shekels of pure myrrh literally weighed 19 and a half pounds. Why is this crazy? Because the way that this works in our life is this. Myrrh represents bitterness. It represents bitterness being distilled. You know that cup that Jesus was like, hey, I want this to pass over me. I don't want this cup, but nevertheless, not thy will, but thy will be done. He says, I need you to take 19 and a half pounds of bitterness onto yourself for that anointing to be on your life. See, some of us say we want the power of God and we want the anointing on our life, but what comes along with the anointing is a cup of bitterness. And I don't know who I'm preaching to this afternoon, and you're saying, God, I want more of you. You got to learn how to drink the cup of bitterness. You got to learn how to drink the cup of hardness. You have to learn how to drink the cup of when people don't walk with you. You got to learn how to drink the cup of people that may scandalize you, talk about you. You got to drink that cup for the anointing. People say they want the anointing of God, but they don't want hardness. You got to realize that if you want greater anointing on your life, you need 19 and a half pounds of drinking the bitterness. Oh, y'all, how many of y'all been through that? Y'all been through some bitter seasons in your life. You've been through some difficulties in your life. When you look back over it, you don't like the way that tastes. You don't like the way that feel. You don't like the way that the season of that life made you feel, but you know that had you not went through it, you wouldn't have the oil that's on your life right now. As a result of your ability to drink bitterness and to be able to walk through life knowing that if I had not have been through that, there is no way in the world I would be here. Come on, look at somebody and say, new oil. Yeah, from my next level. So he says, I want you to take 500 shekels of pure myrrh. And so you got to realize that represents the cup of bitterness. Then he says, I want you to take 250 shekels of sweet cinnamon. So that's literally 9 3/4 pounds of cinnamon. Well, literally what cinnamon means or represents here, it means to be erect, or it means to be upright rose. Or literally what it means is, it means to be sweet under pressure. Lord, have mercy. How many people, that when pressure happens in their life, they lose their sweetness? And, oh, Lord, have mercy. It says here, man, that I want you to take 250 shekels of this, and I want you to be sweet under pressure. That when you're going through life, that does not mean you can cry about it and tell everybody, I'm going through this, I'm going through that. You got to learn how to be sweet under pressure. You got to learn that in the difficulties of your life, to wear a smile on your face. You got to learn difficulties of your life to praise your God and to lift your hands. You gotta learn through the hardness of your life to give God the praise when you don't feel like it. You gotta learn how to walk through hardness and pressure with sweetness. Ah, Lord, have mercy. You know what happens when people get under pressure? They get mean. They don't want to talk to nobody. They isolate themselves. They don't want to be around nobody. But God is saying that this new oil for your next level is going to require for you to walk through all the hardness of your life with some sweetness on your life. Sweetness says, I need you to have 9 3/4 pounds of sweetness on your life. I need you to be able to walk through difficulties with some sweetness on your life, with a smile on your face. Next thing he says, to make this anointing oil, to produce the anointing, you need 250 shekels of sweet calamus. So literally you need 9 3/4 pounds of this plant. Why is this important? Because literally what it was a strip. So literally it was a strip off of a plant that he wanted the priest to be able to smell like. Well, it was literally stripping us and stripping the priest of pride and arrogance. He wants us to be able to walk in humility, to be able to have the anointing on your life. You got to go through a season of stripping to strip you of pride and arrogance, to be able to walk in humility in your life. Lord, I know this isn't a message that the church likes to hear today, but we got to get back to a place of humility. Some of us feeling ourselves way too much, and we're not walking under God's anointing. If you need new oil on your life, you got to learn how to sit low so that he can rise high. In a season of your life, you got to learn how to say, God, I got to put myself down and I got to decrease so that you can increase. Who am I preaching to this afternoon? You say, God, I know that this difficulty is for a reason, because there is new oil that you want to release on my life for the next level. And so you got to learn how to walk in humility. You got to strip yourself of pride and arrogance. God ain't going to do it for you, my dear friends. You got to learn how to strip yourself of pride. You got to learn how to say, God, I may not agree with this, but God, I'm going to do it your way. God, I may not see it, but I'm going to do it your way. For the next level that's on my life, I got to strip myself of this pride. And I got to walk in humility. How many people want more of God? See, this message this afternoon is for the people in the room that says, I want more of God. I know, God, you prepared me for something else, and I don't know why. I'm in a season of transition, and I can't explain it. I don't know why my job is changing on me. I don't know why this is changing on me. I don't know why I'm feeling this way. I came today as a prophet to tell you that God's producing new oil on your life for your next level. Is there anybody here that'll give God praise now for their next level? Come on, shout it! Quarters of this calamus so that you can learn how to have some humility in your life. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Then he goes on and he says, I need 500. This is in the text here. This is crazy what this represents. I need you to take on 500 shekels of sweet cassia, literally 19 and a half pounds. Why is this crazy? Because this was the inferior plant. This was the thing, the plant that didn't even really mean much, but the reality is it was for us to be able to bow down and bend low. for God. God has said, if my anointing and my presence is going to be in my church, people have to learn how to have a deep respect for God. Yeah. Come on, look at your neighbor and say, do you respect him now? Yeah, I know that you come to church for what it does for you, and it has great music, and yeah, it has great family ministries, but the reality is, are you here because you respect God? You can't receive anything from somebody you don't respect. You can't receive anointing from God if you don't respect him. You can't receive the word from me if you don't respect me. And if you don't get to a place of learning respect, you won't be able to receive. And I'm talking to somebody this afternoon saying, God, I need more anointing on my life. And I'm willing to say, God, I'm ready to pop down because what you have for me is greater.
Oh, God, have mercy.
I need you to take 500 shekels of this sweet cassia, and I need you to learn how to bow down in respect, learning how to respect God. That's one of the reasons why you lift your hands in worship, because you're saying to God, I respect you. That's one of the reasons why you stand up in a time when you don't feel like standing up, because you're in the presence of a king. And when you're in the presence of a king, you respect their presence. So you don't come to church to be entertained. You come to church because you're here to respect the king. You didn't come here just for us to sing songs to make you move and to make you shout. I'm here because I respect the king. Is there anybody here that respects the king? I know your neighbor might not respect him, but God has been too good to me not to respect him. He's brought me too far out of danger, seen and unseen, for me not to respect his goodness in the land of the living. Come on, shout. See, my dear friends, a hen of olive oil. He says you need approximately 6 quarts or 6 pounds of a hen of olive oil. But what does the oil represent? The olive oil was used to sanctify the priest, to set them apart for God's use. And I don't know who I'm talking to this afternoon, but some of us have been set apart for the use of everybody else, but have not been set apart for the use of God. Some of us have not been sanctified. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Sanctified, cleaned up, washed up to be used for God. Not to be used for everybody else. Not to do what everybody else say. But to say, God, here I am. Uplifted hands, clean heart to be used by you. I want to be used by you, God. I want to do it my own way. I want to keep going where I want to go. I want to be used by God. Is there anybody here that wants to be used by God? I want to be used by God. So all together here, I'm almost done. All together here, this weighs 64 and a half pounds. This is crazy. All of this together, 19 and a half pounds of pure myrrh, of the cup of bitterness, learning that there's 9 3/4 pounds of sweet cinnamon, 9 3/4 pounds of sweet calamus, 19 and a half pounds of sweet cassia, and then the 6 quarts and the 6 pounds of olive oil, equated to 64 and a half pounds for the anointing oil that the priest had to have on himself every single time he went into the presence of God. Y'all have to realize why this is crazy, because that means you have to clothe yourself every single time you get ready to go into the presence of God. Every single time you get ready to go to church, you got to say, God, I got to get clothed in the right mind. Every time I get ready to encounter God, I got to clothe myself. How many of y'all know that we're not good enough, right? So we got to say, God, I'm sorry every single time. I'm getting ready to enter into your gates with thanksgiving and into your courts with praise. I got to say, God, I'm not clean enough. Wash me. God, I got dirty hands. But God, if you clean me up and sanctify me for your use, you'll be pleased when you get done with me. It says every time they got ready to enter in, they had to be clean with the anointing on their life. This is what God is trying to produce in your life. This is the kind of anointing that God is trying to release on us, not only when we come into the church, but the kind of anointing that he wants us to have at the business table, the kind of anointing that God wants us to have in our families, the kind of anointing that God wants us to be able to have when we're talking to our teachers, the kind of anointing that God wants us to have when we're putting up plans together for our life. God wants us to be able to smell like him. Let's think about what these priests had to smell like with all of these different fragrances and scents. That's why when people say there's something different about you when you walk in the room, because there's an anointing that's on your life. You can't understand it. You talk like everybody else. You dress like everybody else. But because you prepare yourself every single day.
you, because there's a new oil on your life that God is releasing for your next level. I came to prophesy to somebody this afternoon and to say, God, why have I been going through this? It's for preparation for your next level. And if you have learned this, man, if you learn how to say, God, I submit to it, I submit to the pressure of the pain, then God can produce the anointing in your life. Say amen.
Amen.
So why is this important? And I'm almost done here. Think about how they got the olives to actually get to the place of the anointing oil. We're going to have a little bit of church after we get done with this and we're going home. Man, this is a crazy process here. So you realize that these olives actually grew on trees. And these olive trees were actually very plentiful in Palestine. And so what happened was this. When they would get very tender, they would shake the trees and then the olives would then fall to the ground. Some of you guys have been asking God, well, God, why is there a shaking in my life? Why has there been a shaking in my life? I don't know why you changed this and shook this. Why is there a shaking in my life? Ah, Lord, have mercy, because he's getting ready to put you on the process to produce new oil in your life. Then, after this, Lord, have mercy, if the olives were still on the tree, this is for some of us that God has his hand on, but you don't want to let go so quick. If these olives were still on the tree and they wouldn't leave, guess what they would do? They would come by the tree and beat the tree. You don't know why things just can't happen. You're just getting beat up all over the place. That's because God is producing new oil in your life. And then after this, they would take all of these olives and then they would put them in something called an olive press. How many of y'all have been through that season where you've been through the olive press, where all of this pressure is upon you and you can't explain why? All of this pressure has been on you and you feel like everything is rolling over you. You feel like people are advancing and exceeding. You wonder why you can't get to this next place. And you wonder why you don't know how to handle this weight that's on your life. And that's because literally all of that pressure is to produce a little bit of a drop of oil. So Lord, have mercy. If you want a lot of oil, you got to take a lot of pressure. This is why you got to learn how to celebrate people that have learned how to walk through difficulties. Because the reason why they got oil on their life is because they can handle a lot of pressure. Lord, have mercy. And some of us got to get to a place now that when that pressure is on you, you better learn how to use it for good. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with power and the Holy Ghost, and he went around doing good, for God was with him. How many people know that God is with him? Through everything you've been through, all the hell and hot water, let's preach now, all the hell and hot water you've been through, you say, God, you're going to do something in my life. Is there anybody in here this afternoon that says, God, I know it's been difficult, I know it's been hard, but I thank you for the pressure, because the oil's on my life. You got to usher me in to the next place in my life. Let's go, Drew. You got to usher me in to the next place in my life. Eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, neither had it enter in to the heart of me. What God has prepared for me. Is there anybody in here that says, God, I thank you for the pressure. I thank you for the pain. Because my next level requires me to be anointed again. It requires me to walk in with some oil on my life. This business requires oil on my life. This ministry requires oil on my life. This family requires oil on my life. And I don't know why, but I trust you. It feels painful, but I trust you. Lord, have mercy. Y'all know what the Bible says, right? It is the anointing that destroys the yoke. And if you got yokes on your life, the anointing is present today to break the yoke. And so some of us are wondering why we're still struggling with this and struggling with that. Because God is trying to break the yoke off your life. That thing that got you bound, that thing that got you in chains, God wants to break it off of you. Is there anybody in here this afternoon that says, God, anoint me afresh. Break it off of me. Break the chains. Break the sin. Break the habits. Break that. The next level requires me tremble. At the name of Jesus, I want the kind of anointing on my life that when I walk in rooms, atmospheres begin to change. I want the kind of anointing on my life that when any sick are around me, the sick are healed. I want the kind of anointing on my life that attracts finances from the north, the south, the east, and the west. I want the kind of anointing that can set the captive free. Is there anybody in here that wants the kind of anointing on your life when you gotta submit to the pressure and submit to the pain and say, regardless of how hard it is, God, you can trust me. God, you can use me. God, however you want to do it in my life, please, Lord, don't do it without me. Whatever you're doing in this next season of my life, ow, please, don't do it without me. Come on, give him a hand of praise. Come on, give him praise. Don't do it without me. Next level, don't do it without me. God, take me to my next place. I understand now why I've been so hard, because you're walking me in to my next place. And even if I have to walk in late, even if I have to crawl in with a little bit of energy because of the pain, I'ma make it.
Thank you.
prophesy every single Sunday. But one of the reasons why I don't is because there has to be a demand on this room and this atmosphere. Hear me, please. There has to be a demand that when we walk in this room, we're coming to meet God. And there are times I'm standing up here and God is showing me all kinds of things and I just smile at you. Because I don't want the pearls to ever be cast before the swine. I call the new swine. What I'm saying is your spirit has to be in a place of receptivity to hear the word of God. Opportunity, and then when God says it will be a launching pad for what he's getting ready to do in your life. So he says you got to end the season of your life. Be dual. It's okay. You may feel like, I don't want to do this, but take it in this season of your life, because God's going to honor your faithfulness.